Hello programmer, Spide is back with one another project. In this video we are going to learn about hand gesture recognition. So you can see this is how hand gesture recognition is working. You can see my hand movement is detected here, and you can see it is predicting the movement, like what I'm doing. There are 10 classes supported, like okay, peace, thumbs up, thumbs down, call me, stop, rock, leave long, fist and smile. So we are going to implement this project via this video. So in this tutorial I'm just going through how you can implement this project same into your system, what is the requirement of this project and how this code is working. I'm going to explain all these things into video, but before starting the tutorial I'm just requesting you to subscribe our Machine Learning Hub YouTube channel. You will get a lots of tutorial regarding machine learning, deep learning, computer vision and many more things here in this channel. So without wasting time, let's start. So now you will get this code and the written explanation of this project in this blog. I've just around week ago I'm just searching the some blogs regarding this, and I found this article which is very useful, and all the things are explained very beautifully here. You can see all the things are explained very in very deep. So you will get the code of this project in this blog. Actually this blog is not owned by me, I just found it and I found it very useful, then that's why I'm sharing this blog link into my description, and you will get this code into this blog. You can see you can download the code from here. This blog, the already link is given. You can see here you can download the code. So I'm just explaining you how you can implement this project, how you can set up the project, and you can make this project running. Even you can see the demo is given into here. You can see this is the summary and all the things are explained here. So okay, so we are just going to and the first step is you just need to download the code from here. You can just read all the explanation and all the dependencies, all the things are mentioned here. So you can read all the, go through the blog, you will get the idea how it is working. In this video I'm also explaining the same. So let's see. So when you download the code, you will get these things like MP hand gesture. You will get a one code, you will get these names, and you will get the data.pickle file. So this is the structure of the project. So I just assume that you have downloaded the project. Now this project requirement is what? First of all, you should have the OpenCV, like CV2, NumPy, MediaPipe and TensorFlow. Now what is MediaPipe? I think all of you have listened to Keras and TensorFlow, but what is MediaPipe? So let's see, we are going through just MediaPipe sites, development site. So this is the MediaPipe. Now what is MediaPipe is providing? MediaPipe is first of all developed by Google, which is providing you the transfer learning model which is already built, and you can see it is very open source, and you can create a that means application. You can see like selfie segmentation, face maze, all the things are open source. You will get a ready-made pre-trained model, and you can implement your model into your Android application, means you can create a cross-platform application. So this is you can see in this human pose estimation, hair segmentation. So all these things and all the models are open source. You will just use it, and you can deploy this thing into your application. So this is the main thing you need to about see this MediaPipe. So we are using pre-trained model from MediaPipe. So we just need to use MediaPipe for in this project. We are using MediaPipe just for detecting the hand movement, right? Now the another one is TensorFlow. Now we are using TensorFlow for predicting the movement. Just understand the difference. MediaPipe is just for the detecting the movement, but TensorFlow for predicting the hand movement. So now let's see how we are going through this code. Okay, so now first of all we just need to import all this thing. So if you have not installed this library, then just go to command prompt. You just need to do pip install MediaPipe, OpenCV-Python, then NumPy and TensorFlow. If you want to check the version, then let me show you the version of MediaPipe and all. Okay, so which version of MediaPipe I'm using? 0.8.3. Let's check it for the TensorFlow. So okay, I'm using 2.4.1 TensorFlow. So you will get this version, and this is running fine into my system. You just need to import, means this code is already given. You just need to understand how this is working. So now first of all we need to initialize the MediaPipe because we are going to use it. So mp underscore hands is equal to mp dot solution dot hands. So basically what we are doing, we are implementing the hand detection algorithm here. You can see hands.py. So this is the algorithm. Now we are tuning the algorithm. You can see mp hands dot hands, like maximum number of the hands. So in this project we are only detecting one hand at a time. And minimum detection confidence is 0.7, so you can change this confidence value according to your, like you can put 0.567 according to your. Now we need to draw the hand movement onto your system, right? So MP underscore draw is equal to MP dot solution drawing utils. So basically this is just simple like what we are doing in OpenCV, like CV2 dot rectangle, CV2 dot text means you can, how you can put the text and rectangles in you into your frame. So this is a simply drawing utility. Now we need to load the model, and this is the model. So you can see in this model folder you will get a PB file of the Keras and assets. You will get like variables. You can see these all are the hypotheses. Okay, so we need to this load the full folder. You can see MP underscore hands dot gesture. So we need to load the full folder into this model. Now there is a one list here which is containing only the kind of the notepad file. You can see this only contains the name of the gestures. So we need to read that file also, like f.open. Basically we are just using the file function gesture.names, we are reading it, and then we are just splitting with the slash n. Slash n just means what? We just splitting with the enter only. So what we will get? We will get this kind of the ready-made list here. Okay, so you will get this ready-made list. So basically we can classify our result, and we are just printing the labels here. So this is basically our labels of the recognition. Now this is the main part, start from here. Initialize the webcam. So cv2.videocapture0. So if you have external webcam, you can use the one here. If you have any kind of the CCTV webcam, if you want to any use cam, then you just need to put your URL here, right? Now while true, because we are playing with the frame, we just need to go into the infinite while true. Now we just need to read the frame like cap.read. Now this this underscore and this frame. So basically cap.read return a two values. One is the frame and one is the boolean, like true or false. If you are getting the frame, then it will be true, otherwise it will be false. Now we are just checking the shape, like x comma y dot c, y comma c is equal to frame dot shape. Now what we need to do, flip the frame vertically, like frame is equal to cv2 dot flip, and we are just flipping the camera, right? Now we need to understand one thing here. What we are doing is frame RGB is equal to CV2.CVT color, and then we are changing the color format of the our frame, because always remember CV2 always working with the BGR format, right? But if we want to do anything, then we just need to, like if you are playing with any images, like we are doing it SK image or PIL or anything, we need to convert into RGB. But always OpenCV work with the BGR format, so we need to convert this frame into BGR to RGB, right? Because this algorithm is work with the always, obviously it is RGB. So we need to convert the frame before it. Now get the hand landmark prediction. You can see result is equal to hands dot process. Now we are processing the frame. We need to find the hand from the frame, right? So we just need to pass this RGB frame into our algorithm, which is hands dot process. Now we just need to initialize the class name, just empty variable to give the proper hand movement name. Now if result dot multi landmark, this is the method. So with this method we will know, means if any of the hand is detected. If not, then it will don't show anything on the frame. But if your hand is detected from the frame, right? So what it will do, we are just creating the landmark list, empty list. I will explain it later why we are creating the list. Now for a hand LMS in result dot multi landmark, what it will do, when the hand is detected, if the hand is detected, you can see the multiple times of the means multiple points are detected. For so what we are doing, we are iterating each point, and if in result means what we are doing, if result is detected, we are iterating to each points and multi hand landmark. You can see we are using the same method again. If it is detecting, means if the hand is detected, we will go through the whole points of the bunch. You will get if you have not observed, just let me show you the example here. You can see here there is a one picture of hands. Okay, so you can see these all are the points. You can see 0 is wrist, 1 for the thumb. So it will go through each point, right? So that's why we are using the for loop here. Now we need to store the hand landmark, right? We just need to store the height and width. You can see LMX is equal to integer. So what we are actually doing here in LMX and LMY, we are storing the our coordinates, right? Like width and height. Now we are appending this thing into landmarks. So landmarks dot append. So that's why we have created the implicit here. So this is the reason, right? Now what we need to do, we have detected our hand movements, right? You can see these all things are detected, but the main thing is to draw this thing into our real time frame. So what we are doing, mp draw, already we have initialized our drawing method here. So mp draw dot draw landmark, right? So on which frame we need to do, on the our original frame, right? It is bezier frame, it is not rgb, remember that. Onto real frame we just need to draw all the things, and we can, what we are doing in hand lms, we are passing this hand lms, then mp hands, and then hand connection. So basically what we are doing, it will give you the connection like this. You can see all the points are connected here, right? Now our first task is completed, right? What we have done, first of all we have installed the required libraries, we have downloaded the model, we have read the model, we'll just load the label, we are getting the frames, and now our task is completed, which is detect hand movement. Now our hand movement detection is completed. Now what we need to do, we need to predict this hand movement, like what I'm doing a gesture, which kind of the gesture, right? So what we need to do, prediction is equal to model dot predict. Now in model dot predict, in parameter what I have passed is one list, into one list I'm passing another list of this landmark. That's why we have created this list. So into list I am passing the list. So you can understand how this concept, if you pass only this one list, you will get the error. So list into list we are passing, and what we are doing, this prediction will give you the kind of the prediction, like you will get the labels like 0 1, but now what we need to do, you will get a lots of big error, right? So we just need to get the np dot argument max. So what it will give, like 0 1 2 3, you will get like this, you will class like 4, okay, you will get 0, 4 piece, you will get 1, 2, 3, right? So with this np arguments, we can do this, like, right? Now we need to find the proper class name for our movement. So what we are doing, class name is equal to labels. Labels, already we have initialized, this is our labels. And then labels dot class ID. So class ID will be like 0, 1. If I am doing the sign of the piece, right? So what I will get, class ID, I will get 1. And for a 1, obviously it is piece here. So I will get the perfect label name from the labels for the particular moment. Now I'm just doing capitalized because it is written in small. So this is just kind for the good looking purpose. Now what I'm doing, I need to put this result on the main frame. So for CV2 dot put text, what I'm doing is I'm just putting this label into frame. So frame, you can see these all are the like 10 and 50, like axis, like height and width, or not, it is not height and width, it is pixel, like x and y, you can understand, like if you just assume the graph. Now then CV2 dot font hashes simplex, I'm just passing the red color, like 00255, I'm just passing the RGB, and this 2 is a width, means height, width, and we can say width of the font. Now CV2 dot I'm show output, I'm just showing the result frame. If wait key and order Q means, if I'm pressing the Q, then automatically my system means my frame will be closed. And after that, my cap means camera will be released. And after all the things will be done, our CV will destroy the windows. So I hope you get this code. Even this explanation is given in this video also. This article also. So if you want to read the written all the things, you will get this all the things here. You can see the code is, link is already here. You can download the code from here. And the beautiful, you can see the powerful explanation is also given here. Right. You will get a perfect idea to explanation. Right. So now we just, once again we are checking the just our program. So I'm just running it once again. So I'm just starting the my camera, wait for a while and ignore the my background. This is my room, you can see live long, okay, rock, thumbs up, thumbs down, okay stop, okay, let's see. So you can see this this is working fine, but you can see for we have initialized only one hand, so that's why from the frame it is only detecting the one when one hand, you can see here, you can see here, okay, piece, okay, so all the things are working fine here, because I'm not in a perfect environment, I'm in just dull light environment. So you will get a better result if you are in a perfect light environment, right? So I have explained the full running behind, how it is working, means how you can implement this into your system. Okay, so just like and share this video, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me into comment section. I will try to solve your doubt. and you can, we will get the content explanation from this blog as well. So just like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe Machine Learning Hub channel. And you can subscribe this blog also. In this blog there are lots of ready-made projects and articles are available. You will get the code and explanation from this blog also. So I hope you like this video, and like and share, and don't forget to subscribe Machine Learning Hub channel. So guys, see you in the next one. Until that, keep learning, do implement project. If you did not get anything, just comment below. So guys, thank you for the listening me. See you in the next one.